Today's session, we'll learn about the main elements needed for gating system in metal casting process. So here gating system consists of flask made up of wood which holds sand mold. Here drag is the lower molding flask and cope is the upper molding flask. Here parting line is the dividing line between two molding flasks and pattern is the replica of final object to be made with some modifications and mold cavity is made with the help of pattern. Here molding sand is a freshly prepared refractory material. It is the mixture of silica, clay and moisture. Here facing sand is a small amount of carbonaceous material sprinkled on inner surface of mold cavity to give better surface finish to casting. Here cope is used for making hollow cavities in casting. Pouring basin is a funnel shaped cavity on the top of mold into which molten metal is poured. Sprue is the passage from pouring basin to mold cavity. It controls flow of molten metal into mold. Here runner is the passageways through which molten metal flow is regulated before they reach the mold cavity. Here gate is the actual entry point through which molten metal enters the mold cavity. Here chill is a metallic object to increase cooling rate of casting. Here riser is the reservoir of molten metal so that hot metal can flow back into mold cavity when there is reduction in volume of metal due to solidification. In sand mold making procedure, the first step in making mold is to place pattern on molding board. The drag is placed on board. Here dry facing sand is sprinkled over board to provide non-sticky layer. Molding sand is then riddled in to cover pattern with fingers. When drag is completely filled, the sand is then firmly packed in drag by means of hand rammer. The ramming must be proper. After the ramming is over, the excess sand is leveled off with straight bar known as strike rod. With the help of vent rod, vent holes are made in drag to full depth of flask. The finished drag flask is now rolled over to bottom board exposing the pattern. Cope half of pattern is then placed over drag pattern with the help of locating pins. The cope flask on drag is located aligning again with the help of pins. The dry parting sand is sprinkled all over the drag and on pattern. Here sprue pin is located at small distance from pattern. The operation of filling, ramming and venting of cope proceed in same manner as performed in drag. The sprue and riser pins are removed first and pouring basin is scooped out at the top to pour liquid metal. The pattern from cope and drag is removed and facing sand in form of paste is applied all over the mold cavity and runners which give finished casting with good surface finish. The mold is now assembled and mold is ready for pouring.